Hello, my name is Bill and welcome to MindYourCrypto. Today we have Bitcoin and the Feds hiked. We had actually the lowest rate increase since March 2022. Okay, and we are going to see what is going to happen in the market. What does this mean? Because eventually this was the lowest since March 2022, but we still had a rate increase. Let's see what it is going to happen. Eventually, for the crypto market and for Bitcoin in general, we have a very, very nice uptrend rate here. You can see that Bitcoin doesn't seem to want to go down, but at the end of the day, what we are seeing and we are having is a rising wedge pattern in an uptrend. And plus, I will show you something, a quadruple bearish RSI divergence. Now, this case right here is not something to take lightly on, okay? It is not a case that you should be saying, oh, okay, we have a quadruple bearish RSI in the 4-hour frame, nothing special. It usually brings a correction to the market. In the daily frame, what we have right now is a very huge risk. You can see it right here, okay? I would say that there is still a possible chance that Bitcoin would be going upwards, but we are going to discuss a little bit after we discuss the support and the resistance levels that we need to break, okay? And we are here for Bitcoin, and I'm going to draw the Fib all the way from the bottom to the top, right? From the bottom right here towards the top. You can see that we are going to find some major support levels. And we have the first one, which is at 21.8K, followed by another 20.4K. Now, the support level from the previous updates, it was a little bit above, slightly above. You can see it, right? Why is that? I'm going to explain, because eventually we had a new higher high and I had to draw the Fib from the bottom to the newest top that we had today, which was the 24,264. Now, into the weekly scale, remember that we talked about the Bitcoin could even go to 24.8, 24.5, 25K, around there, where the 200-day moving average and the 50-day EMA will probably meet, okay? And it is still possible. However, we are approaching an era that we cannot assume that Bitcoin is going massively all the way up higher. Of course, we are going to experience probably a mini uptrend from now on, maybe another pump. We will see about that. We will see the 4-hour frame. If the 4-hour frame right here ends up green, then this will be good. If not, and it ends up red, then Bitcoin probably is going down. But anyway, we will discuss it further. Okay, for the time being, please pay attention to the very huge risk that we are having with a quadruple bearish RSI divergence in the 4-hour frame, plus the daily frame does not look so great, right? Now, I'm going to talk about the weekly and the monthly frame because no one eventually talks about it right here, but I would think that Bitcoin could go in the monthly scale higher, okay? What I mean by that is, let's say that Bitcoin is going to fall down right here, maybe 19.3K, we discuss about it, okay? It isn't the case that Bitcoin is bearish. I believe that in the next months, Bitcoin is going to start something more impulsive. The 28K is the minimum that Bitcoin will be going to. 28.9, 28.8K around here. It is the minimum that Bitcoin will be going to. Okay, so you should be seeing these prices right here. The first one should be the 27, the second one should be the 29K for the monthly frame. After all, Bitcoin has restarted its bull cycle. I'm very, very sure about it. I think that Bitcoin has restarted its bull cycle. Those that waited the 10K and the 11K and the 13K, it is never going to come. Okay, so eventually for BTC right now, things are looking good. The Fed news were not good news, were not bad. Okay, we had the lowest increase since March 2022, but at the same time, we had an increase. That's all you should be seeing, right? Okay, so eventually I wouldn't say that we are currently hugely bullish with the news. But at the same time, when we go back in the weekly with Bitcoin, it could mean the case that we are going to go higher a little bit to revisit the 24.9, 25k. All right. Now, if the 4-hour frame is red right here and we close as a red candlestick, then what Bitcoin is going to do, it is simply to go further down. Now, this will indicate the start of something more corrective for Bitcoin. This whole price action right here will indicate a possible crash to the downside. And this should be the case that many people will exit the market. Many people will just drop it off. They will say that, okay, forget about it. I am just going to cut off my positions. If they are long right here, for example, then they are probably going to back off. But anyway, for the time being, even if the crash happens and we go down here, we are going further down into the next price target, which will be the 20.5 to 20.4. It isn't an unhealthy correction. It is very healthy. And this is the reason why you should be buying more. With the first correction you're going to have, we should be buying more Bitcoin. We should be buying more crypto, because crypto is here to stay. Cryptocurrency market is the future. And those that disbelieved, that they had a major disbelief in the bear cycle, right now they are seeing that Bitcoin cannot stop to go higher, and they are back to believing that Bitcoin is the future as well. I currently believe that the bear cycle is a time where the crypto companies are building, and now they can, of course, relax, and of course we can all relax, because Bitcoin is back, cryptocurrency market is back. We will go steadily but slowly towards the 30k's and above. Okay, you will see Bitcoin breaking target after target. You will say that, oh, maybe it is the case that I'm wrong, maybe it is the case that Bitcoin is going back to 69 again. And when we break some important resistance levels, the market will restart its huge bullish cycle. What I mean by that is we are going to see huge price action like here. Okay, back in the monthly frame, you can see what we have, what we had, plus 27%, plus 42.79, and so on and so on. The increase was massive, right? Massive increase for BTC. It is going to happen like that, but we need to be a little bit careful as of now. Okay, because until we see these breaking points, we just have to be careful. If you've bought Bitcoin from here or the 16.2k that we discussed about, then you are in the best way to hold it, right? Do not let it go off. If you bought around the top that we are in right now, just be slightly careful about its price action. I'm not sure what we are going to do yet. We will have to wait and see. I believe that in the short term, a price correction will come in and it will shake a little bit the market, but hold it tight. Do not forget to join our monthly subscription, Patreon.com/MindYourCrypto. You are going to have the best crypto trading system in the market as well. Thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic day. See you soon. Bye.